Hey there, everyone. It's me, Esther Barkew, and today I am here to offer you 17 tips and suggestions on how to build up your immune system and move into a space of calm, peace, neutrality. All right, as we are in this time of new territory, uncertainty, and a lot of unknown, and focusing on building up our immune system is a really great focus to have. Now, these tips and suggestions, easy, simple, doable for everyone. Pick what feels right for you, and then bookmark this video so that you can come back and do a few more tips and suggestions in the future. All right, so first of all, number one, be a conscious and deliberate manager of your thoughts, your feelings, your emotions, and what you focus on, okay? Because all of that determines your vibration. And your vibration determines what happens in your physical body, okay? Boosting your immune system. It also determines what you attract and create in your life. I have been talking about this, vibing up, raising your vibration for the last few months over and over again. And that information is very valuable at such a time as this. So focus on things that uplift you, that make you smile, put a warmth in your belly and bring you joy. And what happens then, you raise your vibration and that will bode well for your physical body. It boosts your immune system. If you have not read the book, The Biology of Belief by Dr. Bruce Lipton, okay, or even if you've read it before, this is a good time when a lot of people have some extra time right now to get a hold of that book and read it for the first time. Or, reread it if you've read it before and remind yourself about the power of your beliefs on your body and everything in your life. Okay, very simple, very easy to do. If you did the vibe up with me in December or going through it right now, you've got lots of tips and tools. Also for everyone else, I did a lot of videos on this previously, so please scroll through my youtube.com feed and watch those videos. All right, so number two, if you are at home right now self-isolating, create a schedule for yourself, right? Even if you write it down, I wake up at 8. From 8 to 9, I meditate and have my coffee. From 9 to 9:30, I do self-grooming. I get dressed up. At 10 o'clock, I move my body. At 11 o'clock, I have a late breakfast or a lunch. At 1 o'clock, I'm going to research something that interests me on the internet. At 3 o'clock, I'm going to do something I enjoy, reading, listening to music, watching a video. I'm going to research new jobs. Create a schedule for yourself. Otherwise, you could fall into a pattern of sitting around, scrolling on social media, watching videos, not getting dressed, not taking care of grooming, not honoring yourself. A schedule will make you feel better, to feel on purpose, okay? It will lift your vibration, which will help your immunity system, okay? Excellent. Number three, get outside, okay? Self-isolating does not mean that you have to stay indoors all the time. Maybe you've got a front yard, a backyard. I have a little balcony. You can go and walk, just be practice social distancing from people. Get outside if you can. Put your feet on the ground, lie down on the ground for grounding. Allow Mother Earth to love you, heal you, nurture you, okay, and raise your vibration through her earth frequencies. Okay, very important. This is called grounding. You know, I often talk about back in 2004 when I had my awakening and I was doing a lot of inner work, a lot of release work for about 3 years, 2004 to about 2007 and 8. I would go to the beach almost every day. In the summer, for sure, every day, as long as it wasn't raining. Even in the winter, I would go to the beach and walk along the water. But in the summer, because I lived in Burlington, Ontario at that time, we have the Burlington Beach. I know it's not the great, but but it was perfect for me. And I would lie down on the sand with the sun on my body, cleansing rays. And just saying, okay, Earth, release the negativity, release the resistance from my body. And I could actually feel the Earth, I was on sand, but the Earth, just like a magnet, just pulling everything out of my body. So that was some of the most deep transformative work I ever did. And that certainly raised my vibration, which boosted my immune system. So get outside. Also, sunshine, okay? Sunshine, cleansing rays from the sun, very important. It boosts our mood, it stimulates vitamin D production inside of us. So if you can get outside for 10 minutes, get as much sun on your skin, as much skin as possible. Without sunscreen. Everybody can do that probably for about 10 minutes. That will boost the inner production of vitamin D levels in particular. It'll also boost your mood to raise your vibration and increase your immunity. All right. Please limit your cell phone activity, your social media scrolling and refreshing of the screen, your media TV time. Okay, because that will lower your vibration. In a lower vibration, you lower your immune system. So, yes, I understand we want to check social media, we want to check the news to get the latest updates, get those updates, and then get off. Okay. All right. The exception is if you're using your screen time to listen to a meditation or watch something uplifting, of course, but you know what I'm talking about. Limit your time scrolling and reading all the panic and fear of other people. All right. Next one, of course, the basic one that is going around, wash your hands, sneeze into a tissue. Avoid touching your face. I'm finding that really challenging. I never realized how much I touch my face. And isn't it interesting that we have to remind people to wash their hands? Okay, so keep practicing that. That will also build up your immune system. All right, vitamin D3, vitamin C, and zinc. Get as much of those nutrients, those vitamins as possible, whether it's in supplemental form or food form. Okay, they will be very helpful in building your immunity. Sleep is so important. I know you know this, dear one, and I know some of you struggle with sleep. So identify what it is that's creating lack of sleep. Is it worry, racing thoughts? Then address that. Do your inner work. Reach out. I can help you through session work to calm the mind. Do meditations. Maybe it's your bed. Maybe you don't have an uncomfortable bed, or the temperature in your room is not adequate. I need a cool room to sleep really well at night. I need a really good mattress, and I have pretty great sleeps. Okay, so I enjoy it. We know that when we sleep, our body heals itself. Our body lets go of any resistance. It gives time for our mind to process the information, the events of the day. Okay? Sleep is very important. Please make that as a priority. All right. Next one. This is number 9. If you have access to alternative immune supplements, take them. Not everybody does. I'm here in Bucharest right now. The health stores are pretty good. They have a lot of herbal stores, but because everything is kind of closed right now or on limited hours, a lot of stocks have been depleted. I don't have access to what I would normally have. Okay, but maybe you have some in the cupboard or you can still get some. So if you've got alternate supplements for immune boosting, like oil of oregano, go ahead, use it. If not, go buy yourself some onions. Onions are really good for cleaning the blood. Garlic is going to help you. Okay, and I got more tips coming up. Move your body. This is number 10. Okay, even if you are housebound, you can move your body. First thing I did when I arrived in my apartment here, and what I do as I'm nomading around, is I go buy a yoga mat. Because even if I have a gym close by or there's no gym close by, and even though I walk a lot, I like to have a yoga mat so I can do stretching every day. I do some yoga videos or Pilates videos. You can even just walk in place, swing your arms, move your body. Move your body, okay? That will invigorate your immune system. Of course, avoid alcohol, avoid sugar, processed food, especially in large quantities, okay? Because emotional eating might be playing out for some of you, emotional drinking, emotional shopping online, excessive zoning out in front of a TV screen, watching programs that are not beneficial to you, that lower your vibration. Please avoid all of that. And if you're falling into that as a patterning, you've got the time right now to address it, to do your inner work, okay? And release it once and for all. Okay, vegetables, number 12, vegetables, eat them. Okay, there are still fresh vegetables available. My supermarket has fresh vegetables available. I also brought some frozen vegetables. Maybe you have, the vegetable powders, the superfoods. Make sure you get them into your body to boost your vibration. Fermented food. I went out and I bought sauerkraut. Okay, I bought sauerkraut that has no additional sugar in it. I take about 50 grams every day before my main meal for really good gut health. Okay, so fermented food, probiotics, if you have them, take them. You don't have to buy fancy supplements. Okay, go buy some kefir, go buy some really good yogurt. Get some sauerkraut is my choice. I just love it. Water, hydrate, flush your system, keep the fluids moving through your body. Drink plenty of water. I like to add lemon to my water. And I have apple cider vinegar with the mother in it, which is also helping to boost my immune system. So see if you can find that. Laughing. All right. Remember my naked man story from before? I've done a video about this previously, and laughter raises your vibration. It is such a good activity. It is a good action to raise your vibration. So if you're thinking, well, there's nothing funny to laugh about right now, there's a lot of funny memes going around on social media. When you are there, clue into those, or watch a comedy. Watch a comedy. Watch funny animal videos. I always say Seinfeld makes me laugh. I don't care how many times I've seen an episode. I will watch it. I will laugh. I will lift my vibration and my immunity system. Okay, number 16. If you have access to anything like the red light saunas, do that. Okay, oxygen therapy, do that. Those are really good. Not everybody will have access to it, but if you do, that's my tip number 16. Tip number 17, again, I want to go back to please be a conscious and deliberate manager of your vibration, which means managing your thoughts, your feelings, and emotions. Okay? Nobody can do that but you, and you have full control over that. So, in a time where maybe you feel a little bit out of control, this is something you can control. Now, I'm going to tell you, those are my 17 tips and suggestions. As you can see, they don't cost a lot of money. You can implement many of those right now, and they absolutely do work. Now, I'm going to share with you one of my tips for boosting my immunity system. But before I do that and end off this video, I just want to tell you kind of where I am right now as far as how I'm being guided to be in service to uplift people during this time. I am going to create more videos just like this, okay, with tips and suggestions, but more importantly, to shift your focus, to shift your focus on something positive, uplifting, and helpful. Okay, so if you have any ideas, please put it in the comment section below. I've got a free class. I announced a couple of days ago that I'm going to do a free class. I am going to do a free class. I've actually created the outline for it. It's just the matter of pulling it together. The free class announcement will be made through my newsletter, so please make sure you're signed up for that at whispersfromthesoul.com. Okay. Then I'm also going to be doing some class session work, and we're going to do it at a very special pricing for everybody. Okay? And because it's crazy times, I know there's a lot of financial uncertainty, and even for people who are very abundance conscious, okay, are having a little bit of a wobble. It's okay. It's okay. So there's going to be some special pricing, probably like pick your own tuition. All right? So watch for those. And I'm going to be taking more people on for personal one-on-one sessions to address whatever is coming up for you. So maybe you are deciding, hey, it's time for me to deal with that emotional eating. Or I didn't think I still had this fear inside of me. Let's deal with this. Or maybe you just want some coaching, okay, on steps to take or a reading. I'm going to open up my schedule and take more people. I'll put a link below where you can access information about that. So please stay close. There's a lot coming down the pipeline, and we are doing this together and in a high vibrational group avatar or collective consciousness. All right. And if you have any additional tips on how to build the immune system or something that really works for you, please put it, share it in the comments section below. I know people would love to hear from you. So here's the last tip. I guess this is number 18 then. I am a faster. I have been doing fasting, I want to say almost 2 years now, 2.5 years. At first, I really struggled at getting into intermittent fasting. I had all kinds of resistance happening because of my past with eating disorders, with strange focuses on food, a fear of starvation, all of that. But I moved through all of that, and now I'm an excellent faster. I do intermittent fasting. Sometimes I fast longer, sometimes shorter. I've done very long fasts, and I've done a lot of research about fasting and building the immune system. And you can do your own research. Remember, I am not a doctor. This is just simply information that I'm sharing to you that really works well for me. And what I have discovered that shorter fasting at this time when you're building your immune system is best. So not the 3 day, 7 day, 10 day fasts, the 12 to 18 hour fasts, maybe a 24 hour fast, maybe even up to a 72 hour fast. I've chosen to go shorter. Normally I will fast 18 to 20 hours a day and then have one meal a day, but during this time to boost my immune system based on my intuitive information and the research that I'm doing, I'm narrowing the window of my fasting, and then when I'm eating, making sure to get really good nutrients in. And so the fasting allows your body time to heal, okay, to build immunity, to fight any viruses that are coming around, whether it is the common cold or it is the flu or if it's the COVID-19, just anything. And even if there's something else going on in your body to begin to heal all of that, because your body's not concerned about digesting food. And then something else that I encourage you to research, I've done a lot of research with this as well, is research the topic of autophagy. And autophagy is when you have fasted a certain amount of time and there's different recommendations of what that might be. I've heard anything from after 16 hours to no, you've got to fast 20 to 22 hours before you get into autophagy. You can do that research for yourself. When your body goes into autophagy, basically your body begins to break down your cells, and it begins to, in lack of better terms, it begins to eat the cells that are dead or dying or corrupt and get rid of them. Okay, so your body is really taking care of itself when you move into fasting and then bouts of autophagy, and you can really boost your immune system. So if you've got the time, start investigating about fasting and autophagy, okay? Just something personal I do, and I'm offering that to you as a suggestion. Okay, so thank you for sticking with me. This video did go longer than I expected, but there was a lot of good information that was here. And really, I just want to connect with you. I just want to connect with you and say hello and let you know I'm thinking about you. I'm praying for everybody in my community and across the world, focusing on health and well-being. Love you lots. Ciao.